Okay, what's up, everybody? It's me again, your boy Aaron, aka Mr. Showtime, coming to you, not live, but I got another interesting video. So this is a video request that someone emailed me about, and they wanted to know some of the films that I recommend watching, some of the films that open up to what I've been talking about our alternate reality, about the reality that we're living in is more fake than the reality that we actually live in, which is whenever we meditate and go into a different form of state. But one of the movies I just got done watching was called Dark City. And in Dark City, it involves a guy who basically breaks out of reality that he's been in tune to believe in. In that movie, it's a bunch of dark figures going around harnessing energy, changing people's reality, their perception, and they just keep reverting time over and over and erasing certain memories to where the people, just like us, they run around and they're imprinted with memories, different time zones, different things that are going on with that nature. That movie has everything to do with what we're dealing with now. There's even a realm that they show that the guy who is going throughout the film, who memory was not erased, because remember what I talked about, we all have certain past life memories that we cannot remember, but we keep being imprinted and re-brought into this world. It's almost like living this life one moment, and when this life ends and your avatar dies, your spirit jumps right into another earthly a realm that basically now you're somebody else. But you don't remember your past life, but we've been stuck in a loop doing the same thing over and over. That's what that film is about. But in the end, when he breaks down the system, the so-called, it's just like his own matrix. His city that he lived in was just one city with barriers of walls around it and a body of water, almost like the reality we live in today. Okay? Everybody believes Earth is just this place of a globe, but if you look at Dark City, it's basically from this point, it looks like a circle. If you look above it, yeah, it looks like a circle, but it's actually a doorway, as above, so below. We are here in the movie, they were living up top here, but underneath here, the almost like the other side of our realm of our planet is something completely different going on, as above, so below. If you've heard of that before and never heard of it, look it up. As above, so below. What happens here happens down there, two different areas. In that film, the guy was able to break free from their device, realizing that he has all the power and everything that he thinks about, he brings about. And they kept showing focus on his third eye. They didn't show a third eye in the film and they didn't say your third eye, but that's where that, remember I told you, the God box that you create, that little pineal gland, everything that he thought about came through here and he was able to manifest. And the dark figures tried to go after him because they wanted to put him back asleep, almost like the powers that be here. They don't want us to evolve or remember who we used to be in our past lives, because we were a lot more powerful than this. So again, you're imprinted into this realm as make-believe. What we see, all these houses and cars and clothes and everything beyond these border walls, even when you get on a flight and you think you're flying around the globe, no, they just put a map to make it seem like you think you know where you're going. But in actuality, if you take the globe and just open it up and expand it, you're only going to these four realms of the walls. Notice how every ocean just goes. And you can't see beyond that point. You can't see moon, stars, nothing. It's just a whole thing, okay? That's one movie, Dark City. The man breaks out of the fake reality, evolves, and changes his perception to fit the needs of what he wants to, and he continues on his life cycle. That's one movie. Another movie that's related to that is Total Recall. Total Recall stars Arnold Schwarzenegger. And remember, it's total recall of who he used to be. In the film, he wakes up, he keeps having these dreams of being stuck on Mars, a place that doesn't make sense to him. But every time he wakes up, he's back in his own reality. And he knows for a fact that something doesn't add up to him. So he is not happy with his reality. So what does he do? He goes to a place called Total Recall that gives him memories, puts him in a simulated reality into believing who he chose to be. Before we are brought here into this earthly realm, just like Total Recall, you're given a mission. You chose a mission that when you're imprinted into this matrix that really is supposed to continue, it's not supposed to keep us closed in, but the shit is fucked right now. So just like Total Recall, he chooses the girl that he wants. He chooses the mission that he wants. He chooses the life that he decides to go into. And as he goes into that place called Total Recall that's giving him imprinted memories of a dream that he chose, it went from one point to where he was sitting in a chair. He knew he did this. And then next thing you know, things started to change. And he was like, wait a minute, I just got here. What the fuck is going on? And everything, all the implanted memories that were given into his mind, he thought was reality. So he went through this whole fake reality that was given to him to free people of their minds to go in and understand, okay, you're inside your dream. You're inside your own head. You see how these movies keep telling you you're inside your own head, you're inside your own dream? Total Recall, he goes, saves the girl, starts to remember who he used to be, because at first he couldn't remember. One minute he's being called Quaid, another time he's being called Hauser. You see, he don't remember shit. One minute he's like this and he has these dreams and memories of who he used to be, your ego, and then there's your higher self. The part that you don't remember that you need to be. It's always a catch up. That's Total Recall. In the end, he saves the world. He realizes that, wait a minute, what if this is a dream I'm living in? And the girl says, well, kiss me before you wake up. And then all of a sudden the light goes. Another movie is The Matrix. Same exact concept. You take a guy who's been asleep in an alternate reality. The Matrix has you. The Matrix, this system that we are in, has you in a prison that you can't smell, taste, or touch. You think you're living in this thing we call here, but in all actuality, you're only living inside your head. You're living this, but this is a simulated reality. Your eyes are giving you what you think you want. What you've been trained to believe is real and is fiction and fake. Okay? Matrix. Yeah. Matrix has Neo. Neo goes into... He thinks he's living one life, but he's not satisfied. He always says, do you think that sometimes it feels like you're dreaming or you're still awake? Another dream reference. You don't know whether you're sleeping or awake. Remember how they tell us, when we're sleeping, we're more awake than we are when we're awake and conscious in this reality that we see. We're in a prison of our own mind. Whatever you're thinking about right now is shaping your reality. You just can't, you don't believe it because you weren't taught so. Going with Neo, they checked him out and said, you're living in the Matrix. They had to get to him mentally and say, mentally, if you in this world decide to make a choice that you want to learn about the truth, the choice altered his reality and made him see with his third eye, which they didn't reference this really. And he went into his mind. They said, this is the real world that you're living in. It's not love. It's not this. It's actually a prison. Housing units, this, that, all that shit. But you thought it was real the entire time, but you're actually living a lie. Like today, Neo goes through. He realizes the truth that's being told, that he's living in a box. A simulated reality, Zion, because the true world has been blinded over him. All these movies I just mentioned to you, Dark City, Deception, sleeping, waking up from a dream. The other one I just mentioned, Truman, no, I didn't get to Truman Show yet. Dark City, Total Recall, and this one I'm talking about, The Matrix. The next one I want to talk about, because everybody's seen The Matrix. If you haven't, go look at it. Same thing. Person altering reality living in this fantasy world. And as you unlock the true nature of who you are in your head, you can levitate and fly. You can create everything. It's just that, again, the system we're living in that you don't see, that they lied to you about, telling you, oh, no, gravity exists and you can't do this and this is impossible and this is that. Same exact shit. But when you break out of that prison of your mind, which you withhold yourself, this shit, but you don't realize it. Matrix. Let's go into Truman Show. Same exact contact. Little kid put into a world that he was told is real, but in all actuality, it wasn't. Truman started to realize something don't add up here. Some shit don't make no sense. That's his consciousness waking up. Realizing that his universe, his world, his reality has been twisted and tainted. You see how all these, I just named a bunch of movies. See how all of them correlate to the same exact thing? It's not just these films, they're all talking about the same thing, which is reality. Everybody's wondering what this altered reality that you're living in right now, which don't make sense to you, because I know a lot of you are looking at shit and say, some shit just don't add up. It just don't make sense to me. But you're being played in front of your eyes, the veil of what's going on. So Truman Show, he goes through, he starts to question his reality. The powers that be start to tell him, no, deviate. This is, no, please listen to me. You're going crazy. You're going insane. They wanted to put him back in a box. But when he started to break the barrier and then started talking with the man upstairs, really he was kind of understanding and breaking free. They didn't want him to leave. They said, you've been inspiring people. You're on television. You're in an alternate reality. None of this shit is real. He said, fuck that. I got in a boat. I went beyond the shores. That's another thing. They always show beyond the shores. When a person tries to go beyond the shores, they see shit that they don't expect. And most of us here living on Turtle Island, America, we have not gone about the Great Walls. Or at least most of us don't remember that shit. How many of you have actually been to the far reaches of the earth that they tell you you could not go to? I would say nobody. Because they don't want you to know that shit. They don't want you to know that there are other things that exist out there except this little box they have you in. Truman Show, he went, he swam, he said, fuck that, let me get out of here. He walked up to the steps, opened the door, and went to the real. He made the choice to say, I'm not in this illusion anymore. He evolved. That's him metaphorically evolving. What other films? There's a bunch of them. Oh my goodness. Another film that's similar to this is, let me see, I did Total Recall. I did Matrix. Let me see. I would say Jumanji is another reference where you're playing a game. You get sucked into this game that's not real, but you believe that it's real and you have to go through. I mean, I could use that, but no, not really. But just you, from what I'm showing you, from all the things that I'm talking about, I want you guys to realize. Gods of Egypt showed a reference of the earth, where it flipped over like a coin, where it showed this is the one plane, but when you flip it over to the bottom, remember north, south, flip as above, so below, just like the north and the south, they're actually the same thing, except one realm exists bigger than the other one. So looking at these movies, putting these pieces together, you start to understand that they're telling you this. The TV show Dome, Under the Dome, I think it's by Stephen King or some shit like that. A town put in a glass dome. Now before that, they knew, okay, our town was open, but all of a sudden this dome got placed that they don't know where the fuck it came from. They thought they were living in one peaceful town but then next thing you know, some dome came over. That reference of a dome is telling us the same thing. Globes. When you go and you see those snowing globes that you take and you shake around and it's like, look, it's snowing in the little village. Same reference. It looks like this on one side, but it's really flat. the globe, the hemisphere, the atmosphere that we're living in is a dome, a matrix dome that's been constructed. And most people will say, I don't believe it, I don't believe it. Yeah, because you haven't researched it, you haven't studied. But ask yourself this question. Why do all these movies keep referencing the same thing? And don't say it's for entertainment. What is entertainment supposed to do for you? Entertainment is putting shit in front of your face, calling it entertainment, when in actuality, you don't even realize that they're telling you what the... They're mocking you. They're making fun, saying these people don't even realize that we put them in a box. And again, remember I said you're in a box because of the cycle that you live. A year, 365 days after that, it ends, it starts all over. 365 days this year, 365 days again. The same holidays, the same people talking about all this time. Let's talk about this person. Let's talk about the Dr. Martin Luther Kings. Let's do this. Let's talk about this. Where is the new shit? All these events that are going on right now are just honestly recreations of what the fuck had happened before. Under the Dome, The Simpsons talks about the Dome in their movie. The Simpsons movie, shit happens, they're being patrolled, a dome gets placed under them. Simpsons always referencing the Dome. They tell the truth all the time, but they must put it in a form that's make-believe, that you believe is fake, but in actuality it's real. They have to show you this shit in order to get you in that mindset to believe. If they don't show you it, then you don't know what to believe. They need to show you, oh, cartoons aren't real. They're just imaginary things that we make up. Yeah, keep believing in that bullshit if you want to. Or you can go to the other side and actually start asking questions. Go internally in your mind. Start to question this whole fucking system. Think about it. Same concept over and over and over and over and over. Every year, it's the same goddamn thing. We keep celebrating the same fucking events over and over and over. Yay, another St. Patrick's Day. Yay, another this. Yay, another that. Yay, another this. I can't wait for a new year. All you're doing, if you were to get rid of calendars and times and space and shit, it's just a plan. It's just there is no night and day. It's the same playing field. If you got rid of a clock right now, you think time is going to stop? Yeah, time will stop according to you. But if time stops, shit, that's time, not your existence. If all the clocks were to stop right now, yes, time stops, but existence won't. You won't freeze unless you're stuck in a time warp. But think about this. The every day that you wake up, the tree's still there. This is still there. The sun goes up. The sun goes down. You go to sleep. You wake up. When you go to sleep, you're having dreams. You're having vivid dreams. You're having nightmares. Some of you are, I don't understand this. I've seen this. I've seen that. And then some of you say what you saw, it came true. That feeling of deja vu you get, that feeling of deja vu is you relived this shit before. You just can't remember it. So therefore, you're thinking to myself, what's this total recall I have going on right now? Research it. Reincarnation exists. Past lives exist. Energy exists. Realms exist. Ancient things and things that they didn't tell you about exist. You were just told this thing that we're living in right now, this thing that we're living in of you believing that you must work, that you must get that promotion, that you must do these things. It's all a dream. We're all living in dreamland right now. I hate to break it to you, but yeah, you're living a dream right now. And in your dream, you're wondering, well, why can't I float? Because you've been taught, you don't believe you can do certain shit. So therefore, this is how small you are to yourself. You place yourself in a box. These movies are telling you people flying out of nowhere, floating in midair, people reading everybody else's minds and stuff, magical shit happening, stuff that you see that you can't explain and all of a sudden it doesn't exist. When you look into a mirror and you see certain shit in the mirror, but when you see it in your reality, your perception has been tainted. Yeah, mirrors are gateways to the other realm of what's going on. Why do you think most people, they always say what, like, certain creatures, if they look in a mirror, they, this shit don't exist because it's in your head. Go look at these movies. Go look at these films. Start there with these references. Any movie that has to do with altering reality, perception, living in a different reality, living in some type of perceptional reality. Look at, Virtuality Man or something? I think it was with Keanu Reeves. That was Denzel Washington. There were two different movies like that. Keanu Reeves, I believe, was in a movie about virtual reality simulations, and Denzel was in a virtual reality simulation. What he believed to be perceived, what he thought was real. Remember, they had him in that machine and they hacked them into their brain. Matter of fact, when you look at the shit, when you go back and look at that film, there were references to snakes, serpents. Create the snake, the genetically modified snake. You cut it off and then the forms and cells. And there was points to where they were taking cubes. They were taking cubes out of snakes. That little Metatron cube, this thing right here, the Metatron. The cube. The all source of creation, the all spark. Yeah, all this is connected. But it's up to you to decide whether it's fake or fiction. And if you keep living in this alternate reality, look at how, seriously, instead of saying, oh man, you talking crazy, sit back and think about it. I know all of y'all have before. And if you haven't, you've thought about this shit. You just went about your merry lives because you have to work in order to stay busy. They need to keep you busy at all times, working long hours so you can't live, going to sleep being exhausted. When you're doing one thing, something else is going on behind your back. It's the magical trick. Pay attention to this while something else is going on in the background. That's what news forecast does. That's what television does. Tell your lies. Television to your lies. Again, these are people who are in makeup on TV to feed you what... Who's running this system right now? Ask it, is it you? Is it the people? Or do you believe it's the people? The same presidential rat race? Who's going to win? Who's going to win? I'm better than you. I'm better than you. Yes, vote, 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 vote. And then when you don't get what you want in your perceptional reality, oh, we still don't get food stamps. Oh, we still don't get the president we want. Oh, this shit is still fucked up. It's just a war back and forth, back and forth, back and forth. A war on consciousness. We need to keep the people busy so they don't stop and think and say, this is stupid. Why do we keep voting the same people? Why do we keep living the same fucking lie? Why do we keep doing the same thing as a collective unit? Think about it. Your perception of reality is false. When you go beyond, and like I said, when you meditate, you're going in your own head. When you go in your own head, because remember, your head is playing out what you see all the time. Total recall, false illusion, false elimination, what the veil. Every movie that has to do with revealing, putting veils in front of your face, shit that you can't see, the supernatural. I mean, for goodness sake, look at how many remake movies they do. It's the same thing over and over and over and over. They keep making remakes for the kids so that eventually, shit, each generation that dies off ain't gonna remember shit because they keep twisting the reality. They keep making shit new because they need these new breeds and new babies that come into this world to understand something. It's either you're a slave or you're somebody who's thriving. Same goddamn war over and over and over and over and over and over and over because of this. Most people would say this is the Illuminati symbol. No, this is 666. Six electrons, six protons, six neutrons. They need you to believe certain numbers mean something. So therefore, when you believe it exists, therefore you're creating your reality. What you believe exists. You believe like Peter Pan, use your imagination. You believe certain shit exists, your eyes will tell you what you see. Your eyes are the trickery and the foolery. That's why some people can see what you can and you and vice versa. The moment you snap out of your own shit and you start to realize, oh my God, something that said so you, when you start, people are starting to realize something ain't right. The Wizard of Oz, the Wizard of Oz, same concept. The Land of Oz, everybody believed there was this great and powerful wizard who was running everything. But really, it was smoke and mirrors in the background. That's an old ass reference. The veil that is beneath your eyes, wanting this. I want a heart. I want a brain. I want a love. I want to do this. I want, I want, I want, I want, I want. And I got to go to this Oz in order to get it. When in actuality, you had the shit the whole time. But you think you got to go to a source that is controlling everything. Blah, 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 blah. What do you think people who try to unveil the truth, they die? Because they don't want people to know we're controlling the masses. We need you to be in fear. Remember I told you how movies alter, like, fuck with your reality? They need you to be fearful. They need you to be scared right now. They don't want you to be happy and believe that you can be the power that be. They need you to stay in this state of mind. They need you to do that. What foods are you eating right now? Are you eating fruit from the earth that's naturally and not sprayed from the shit from the skies or the pesticides? Are you eating fruity pebbles and are you eating snacks and shit that you believe is good for you? Oh, these are just spices and shit that they put on food. No, it's not. It's made to taste good. It's poison tasting good. Research that shit. Do it yourself. Red dye, yellow fever, red five. The fuck is that? Is that from the earth? I don't. When I pick up a plant, what's in it? Red dye? No, it's from the earth. So actually eating from the earth will live you longer versus shit they chemically created in the lab. I know it tastes good. I know it does. Hell, I fall victim to it sometimes. We all do. Taste buds. They have to make something taste good, but put something deadly in there and see how long you live. Look at the rate of everybody going right now. Everybody's dying. You know why? Because you're not eating real food. You're eating chemically processed shit with starches and all this other stuff. That ain't real food. You know you can put hallucinogens in people's shit? You can. They know all of this stuff. You've been living in a dreamland, Neo. Who's the crazy one? The one who's thinking outside the box? Or the one who does the same exact shit all the time? These four walls here, this is the prison that they had you in. They expect you to think, oh, I'm going to find you and do this and insert. No, they did it to yourself with this shit right here. Welcome to the prison of your mind. It is your job to escape it. Your ego is what they created. Be like this. Be like this. Be like this. Be like this. Don't you like candies and rainbows? Yeah, I like it. Go to your mommy and daddy. Put you in a box. Put you in a box. Train you to believe certain shit. Then you grow up and you treat your kids the exact same way. And you talk to your parents a certain way. That's called an ego trip. That's what we've all been given, a mask, an ego mask over on the inside. How are we really feeling? You're going out in public flossing and looking good, but then when you revert, how are you actually feeling on the inside? You showing some shit on the outside, but how do you actually feel on the inside? See the difference? What are you showing versus what you really feel like? Think about that.